Dr. K. S. Ramakrishnan is working as an assistant professor, School of Education, Tamil Nadu Open University, Chennai 15. He has been teaching science education, environmental science, educational technology and research methodology in various colleges of education and Tamil Nadu Open University for the past 9 years. He has guided so many M.Ed., M.Phil and Ph.D. students. His current research areas are environmental education, educational technology and media and communication. He has conducted various workshops on ICT usage in education, Wiki Educator, e-content development and educational research methodology. He had attended many online workshops on Moodle learning analytics. He has published 6 books and many articles in national and international journals of repute. He regularly gives plenary and keynote speeches on environment and ICT related issues at various national and international conferences. He has delivered 28 episodes of the program Pudiyodor Ulagam at All India Radio, Chennai, related to various new developments in science and technology.
Welcome to UGC CEC program. In this episode, we will discuss about the concept of mean or average or arithmetic mean. So, in this episode, we will discuss about the meaning of mean, the calculation of mean by various methods, the interpretation of mean, the situations where mean is used, and the advantages and limitations of mean. So, all these concepts we are going to discuss today. Now, let us see what is mean. The arithmetic mean, that is more commonly known as the average. That means, it is the average value of a set of numbers. That means, suppose if some data is given, you have to add all the data and divide by the total number of terms, then that is called the average, and in technical term that is called the arithmetic mean. And we can use it for the interval and ratio data. It can also be used for dichotomous variable. That means, the dichotomous variable is having only two values, either 0 or 1, and the interval scale already we have discussed, and the ratio scale, and these are starting from 0 and they are having an interval, and therefore, the arithmetic mean can be used or can be calculated in so many situations. For continuous data, the mean is calculated by adding up all values and dividing by the number of values. And therefore, by that way that we can calculate the mean. And now, let us take a sample set, and the mean of a sample is denoted by a bar over the variable, and that is x bar. And therefore, the mean, that is x bar, that is equal to the summation of x by n, and this means we are adding all the values where I is ranging from 1 to n, and therefore, that can be given as x 1 plus x 2 plus x 3 and so on divided by n. And the same thing is written here, x bar is the arithmetic mean, x 1, x 2, x 3 are the values of the variable, and sigma is the total and n is the number of items. And the mean of a population is denoted by the Greek letter mu. Dear friends, throughout statistics we are using two terms, one the population and another is a sample. The population includes all the items which we are considering. See, for example, the population of India, it is around some 130 crores, and it is not possible to take all the population for an experiment or for a survey, and therefore, we are selecting a sample, and therefore, the population is having its own average and its own standard deviation and all, and the sample that is having its own average and standard deviation. Ideally speaking, the standard deviation and mean of the sample must be equal to the population average and the standard deviation. And therefore, throughout the statistics, we are using the term mu for the population and x bar for the sample. and therefore two terms that we are using. And now how to calculate the mean in ungrouped data? And for example, you take ungrouped data, that is 20, 28, 34 and so on and so forth. As already we have seen, the arithmetic mean is calculated by adding all the values and dividing by the sum of the number of items, and therefore the x bar is equal to summation over x by n, and that is equal to, we are adding all the values and that is giving 534. The number of terms or items, that is 10, and therefore the average, that is equal to 53.4. And in case if the data that is given in terms of the scores and frequencies, see, consider this case. Here the number of fruits in a tree, that is given, so it is ranging from 0 to 10, and the number of trees which are having that many number of fruits, so that means 6 trees are having 0 fruits, 11 trees are having 5 fruits, and only 1 tree, that is having 10 fruits. And therefore, when the scores and their frequencies are given, how to calculate the mean? So, here the formula is slightly changed, and the mean, that is given by summation over f into x by n, where f is the frequency and x is the value divided by n. That means the frequency is multiplied by the value, and that is summed up, and therefore in this example you can see 5 into 0 0, 5 into 1 5, and like that 7 into 2 14, and therefore this column, that is giving the product of f into x, and therefore here we have calculated f into x and we have summed it up. So, the summation of f into x, that is equal to 207, and the total number of items, that means the total of the frequency, that is equal to 50, and therefore the mean, that is given by the summation of f into x by n, that is equal to 207 by 50, and that is 4.14. And therefore, by using this formula, we can find out the mean when the scores and their frequencies are given. Now, let us take another example. When the class intervals and frequencies are given, there is a difference between this and the previous one, and here the scores and their frequencies are given, here we are not giving the class interval, and in this example the class intervals are given, 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30 and so on, and the frequency is given. It is somewhat similar to the previous case, and now let us see how to calculate the mean. And here it is a class interval, 0 to 10, 10 to 20 and so on, and the frequency, and now we are finding out the midpoint of the class interval, that means 0 and 10, the midpoint is 5, 10 to 20, the midpoint is 15 and so on, and therefore this column is depicting the midpoint 5, 15, 25 and so on, and the same formula that we are using, f into x. The only difference here is instead of taking the value, that we are taking the midpoint. And in the same way that we are multiplying the midpoint and the frequency, that is 5 into 13, 65, and we have calculated all that, and now we are summing of f into x, that is equal to 1360, and the same formula we are using, the mean is equal to summation of f x by n, that is equal to 1360 by 60, that is equal to 22.66. And so, we have found out how to calculate the mean in these two situations. The only difference is that in the first example, the scores are given, and the second example, the class intervals are given. In case if the data set is somewhat small, then easily that we can use this formula and we can find out the mean. In case if the data set is very large or if the values are very large, and here you see the values are somewhat small, 13, 20, 6, etc. And so easily that we can find out the product. But in case if the values are very large, 1000, 3400, something like that, then this formula cannot be used, and therefore we are introducing another formula, and that is the assumed mean method. More or less the formula is same, but slightly that we are modifying the formula, and now let us see how to calculate the mean by using the assumed mean method. So when the data are small, the previous methods are okay, but when the data are lengthy, as I have told you, very lengthy or very large, we use the shortcut method, and here we are assuming a mean, that is called the assumed mean, and the deviations of items from the assumed mean are first found out, and they are multiplied by their respective frequency, and the total of those product divided by the total frequencies and added to the assumed mean, and the resulting figure is the arithmetic mean. Therefore, let us take an example, and first we have to arrange the data in the tabular form. The class interval which lies at the middle of the distribution is located. This class interval is taken as the assumed mean, that is AM. And we have to assign 0 to this class interval, and assign minus 1, minus 2, etc. to the class intervals above it, and plus 1, plus 2, plus 3 to the class intervals below it. This is represented by D, that is the deviation, and we have to find out the frequency into deviation, and we have to sum up, and by putting the summation of F into D, in the formula we have to find out the mean. That means we have to assume a mean. That means suppose if the class interval that is going on, what is the mid class interval, that is taken as the assumed mean, and we have to assign a number 0 to it, and whatever is above it we have to give minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, etc. because they are preceding, and whatever below it plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, etc. And we have to multiply this by the frequency, and these are called the deviation, and the deviations are multiplied by the frequency, and that product is summed up, and then we have to add it to the assumed mean. So now let us take an example, and here the formula x bar, that is equal to A, that is assumed mean, plus summation over F into D, where F is the frequency and D is the deviation, and multiply by the size of the interval I, and divided by N, where N is the total. And now the example, it is a class interval and the frequency, and here there are some 5 class intervals are there, and we are choosing the mid of the class interval, that is taken as the mean class, and we are assigning 0 to that. And as we have already seen, all that above they are given minus 1, minus 2, etc., and all below they are plus 1 and plus 2, and therefore the deviations are assigned. And now we have to multiply the deviation by the frequency, that means minus 2 into 13 minus 26, minus 1 into 20 minus 20, 0, 10 and 22. And therefore, if we take this as the midpoint, all that above they are having a minus sign, all that below they are having a plus sign, and now we have to add them up, and that is what is given here. All the negative FD, that is giving minus 46, all the positive FD is giving 32, and therefore if you are adding 46 and 32, that is giving minus 14. Now, let us have a break. Now, let us continue. We had calculated the summation of f into d, that is minus 14, and now we have to put into the formula that a, the assumed mean, and here it is 25. Why it is 25? Because the 20 to 30, that is taken as the mean class, and therefore the mid value of 20 and 30, that is 25, and therefore that is assumed mean 25. And summation of fd minus 14, and so by putting all the values into the formula, we are getting x bar is equal to 25 plus minus 14 into 10 by 60, and that is equal to minus 140 by 60, and that is giving the value 22.66. And now, my dear friends, by using this formula, we can handle very lengthy or very big numbers also, because we are only assigning the deviation, and the deviation is somewhat 0, minus 1, minus 2, plus 1, plus 2, etcetera. And therefore, we have to multiply that by the frequency, and therefore, that is much less or much easier than the previous method. And therefore, this method, and that is very much useful. And you could have seen, there is no difference by the method, all are giving the same value, and therefore, whichever method that you want to follow, that you can, but whichever is easier, we can calculate the mean value in an easy way. And therefore, we have calculated the mean value by various methods, for ungrouped data, for grouped data when the frequencies and the values are given, when the class intervals are given, or when we are using the assumed mean method. And by any method, we can calculate the mean. And now, how to interpret it, the interpretation of mean or the average. Now, let us see. The mean represents the average of all the values, and therefore, whatever values, so it is giving you the average, and it is well balanced. And the sum of deviations of scores from the mean is always 0. That means, because the mean is occupying the midpoint, and therefore, whatever values above are equated by the values below, and therefore, the sum of the values above is always equal to the sum of the values below, because the mean is well balanced, and it gives weightage to all the values. We have already seen the median and mode, and they are not affected by the extreme values. In case if you are adding one value or subtracting, or if you are changing the value, then that is not affecting the median and mode also. But as far as mean is concerned, it is taking into consideration all the values, and therefore, it is much more accurate than the median and mode. And the representative of all other values, because it is representing all other value, that means the mean value is the representative of all the values. That means we can forget about all the 100 values. Instead, that we can talk or we can discuss only the mean value, and it is a center of gravity. Center of gravity means, suppose you take an object, and where the center of gravity, that is balancing the left side and right side. And therefore, in the same way, the mean or the average, that is balancing the left and right, and therefore, it is called the center of gravity. In physics, we have discussed about the center of gravity. The center of gravity is a point which is balancing the object. That means, the mass of the object, which is left hand side, is equal to the mass of object on the right hand side, and therefore, it is balancing. In the same way, we can take the analogy for the mean also. the mean that is dividing the points into two, and it is balancing the lower side and the upper side, and therefore it is called the center of gravity of all the values. And therefore, the mean value, that is very important to be calculated. Now, let us see what are the uses of mean, and when the average performance of a group is required, mean is better than the median and mode, because it is balancing, it takes into consideration all the values. And when center of gravity of a sample is needed, and when standard deviation, correlation, etc. are to be calculated, that means the mean value can be further analyzed, but the median and mode, they cannot be further analyzed, but the mean can be analyzed, and therefore the mean is useful in the standard deviation, correlation, etc. And when the data is uniformly distributed, and when precise comparisons are required, because the mean is very precise comparison. And now, the advantages of mean: it is well defined and free from any bias, it is based on all observations of data, it cannot be calculated even if a single item is left out, and it can be treated for further analysis. It is easy to calculate and simple to follow. If a number of items in a series is large, mean provides a good basis of comparison and least affected by the fluctuation. So, these are all some advantages. And what are some limitations? Sometimes abnormal items may considerably affect the average. See, for example, you take a situation where most of the values, they are ranging from some 40 to 60. If only one value, that is going around some 90 or 99, etc., that is called the outlier, but that is seriously affecting the mean. That means, when the real situation, most of the values are ranging from 40 to 50, because of that one particular value, the whole mean, that is taken into some other point, and therefore, these outliers are highly affecting the mean. It cannot be calculated even without a single item. This is not the case in median or mode. So, there are some limitations also. Suppose if a data set is having a missing value, and we have to calculate the approximate average or the approximate central tendency. So, what to do? We have to skip mean, and we have to take the median or mode, because they only can accommodate a data set where a missing value is also there. And therefore, that is a limitation of the mean, and many times the mean may not be in the series, and sometimes the average values may yield absurd result. For example, 3.7 child, that means the okay, it is average, but sometimes it is meaningless also, 2.3 persons and 3.7 girls. What do you mean by 3.7 girls? Either it is 3 girls or 4 girls. But anyhow, as we have calculated the mean value, it is not having the real meaning. So, it is an observed. And therefore, these are all some limitations associated with the mean. Now, let us summarize what we have discussed so far. And in this episode, we discussed the definition of mean. We had dealt with the calculation of mean for ungrouped data, and when the class intervals and frequencies are given, and the assumed mean method. We had also discussed the uses, advantages and limitations of mean. So, all that we have discussed so far, and now let us have some questions. The first question, define mean. The second question, shall we use the mean for dichotomous variable? The third one, mention two advantages of mean, and the fourth one, why mean is called the center of gravity of the data, and write two limitations of mean, and the last question, mention an example when the mean gives observed result. And so, with all this, we are completing the session now, and thank you.